Well, good morning and welcome to the lake. It's a blessing to be out here in the beautiful outdoors. And as we gather for worship today, have a special announcement. I'm going to invite Shannon Jenks, if she will, to come forward and share with us some important information regarding Ryan's case for smiles.
Kathy's going to be my visual person for this, but first, I just want to thank the congregation. She's my Vanna White. First, I just want to thank the congregation for believing us and the generosity that you extended us for the second quarter coin offering. Absolutely just blew us away as far as how kind you were. We're going to have our first fundraiser, and our first fundraiser is going to be mostly a back-to-school theme, and we have two back to school prints. One of them is school buses. The school starts on the 13th of August, so it is just a couple of weeks away. And then we have another one that is more encouraging words. And then we also have another print that is a happy birthday, and that is the one that we have the fewest of. So all of these are limited. So when they're gone, they're gone. And then the last print we have is a tiger print for your favorite tiger or future tiger. And we have some of them here today, and Ann will have some in the office also. 100% of the proceeds goes right back to our chapter. And wanted just to share that with you, that it all comes back into this community to help put more smiles and pillowcases into our children's hands and beds. But the pricing on them are $15 each, or if you buy two of them, they're $25. So if you're interested, you just grab Kathy and I afterwards, or if you want to reserve a special one that you want to pick up in the next week or so, let us know. But also Ann will have them in the office. So again, thank you again for your support and generosity. I would never have believed that this mission has gone as far as it has. Thank you.
Amen. Thank you, Shannon, and thank you, Vanna White, for helping out this morning. As we begin worship, just wanted to say a huge, huge, huge thank you to David Rich and Flying Brian for help get us set up this morning with audio as we begin worship this morning. I'm going to invite you to stand if you're here with us in person as we begin with a word of prayer. God, thank you for this beautiful day that you have created. God, thank you for inviting us to walk with you today. God, as we worship, draw each one of us close to you. And we thank you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Jesus, Lord, Please join me in the call to worship. Come, now is the time to worship.
You are welcome here.
Bring the worries of the week, your troubled thoughts.
You are welcome here.
Bring your weaknesses and your regrets.
You are welcome here.
Bring your deep needs and your lofty dreams.
You are welcome here.
You are welcome to be yourself.
You are welcome just as you are.
Come, now is the time to worship.
We are all welcome here.
At this time, I invite the children to come forward for our time together. As you're coming forward, the ground is kind of wet, so we'll either stand or kneel. If you want to stand, I'll go ahead and kneel. I can wipe moisture off my knees. Actually, it's not too bad, but your pants will definitely get wet if you sit. So come on over. Yeah, whatever works best for you, okay? Good to see you. Gosh, are you having a good morning? Are any of you guys going up to the dunes today? That'll be a lot of fun. I love that place. The theme word today is reach. So the first thing I want us to do is let's reach. Can you reach real high? Yeah, just stretch. And can you reach to the right side? And can you reach to the left side? Can you reach behind you? And all around. Yeah, reaching. We're all supposed to reach all around. Well, that theme of reach is reaching out with Jesus, with God's love to all the world around us. You know, God gives us a lot of different kinds of gifts, and you've probably heard that before. Can you name some of the gifts that God gives us?
Life.
Life, that's a big gift. Yeah, anyone else?
Love.
Love, yeah. How about the ability to help others, the ability to teach, the ability to provide music is a wonderful gift, the ability to be a good thinker and organizer. There's all kinds of gifts that each of us have. Athletic ability that you can use for yourself to give glory to God and to teach others. So, yeah, all of those, yes. The ability to learn, that's really very important. The greatest gift that God has given us of all the gifts is one I think you mentioned, the gift of love. And in fact, that was Jesus' greatest commandment, love God and love others as you love yourself. Am I getting feedback here a little bit somehow? I'm okay? Okay. And love others as you love yourself. Now, I want you to do something for me. I want you to look around right in here and look for the face of somebody that you don't know very well or don't know at all. Somebody fairly close, somebody that you don't know very well. Can you do that? Look for somebody that you don't know very well. Okay. Now, remember who that person is, okay? I am going to give each of you 3 pieces of candy.
So, candy?
Yeah, candy. One, two. Try to give you a variety here somehow. Got to get 3 more, or you're out of luck. No. Okay, now I have some instructions for that candy. As you set it, as you hold it, I want you to set one piece down for yourself, and that signifies that you love yourself. Then I want you to set a second piece down to represent that you love your mom or dad, and that piece will be for them, okay? The third piece I want you to give to that person that you don't know very well. Now, normally you wouldn't go and visit strangers, but I'm sure this is pretty safe. You wouldn't do that without your mom and dad. But all I want you to do is just to walk to that person you don't know, hand them that piece of candy, smile, and come right back to me, okay? So go do that. Take one piece, just one piece to somebody you don't know, and hand it to them and smile and come right back. Just one piece. Somebody you don't know. That guy right in front of him. Maybe you don't know him. Oh, you got one. Oh, that guy right there. He looks pretty dangerous. There you are. Okay. You got your candy? Okay. Was that scary?
No.
No. Well, good. Did it feel good? It feels good to do things for others, to give to others. God wants us to share his love, and that's an example or a way of showing God's love for others. That's a way of reaching out to others, and especially those that we maybe don't know, with kindness and love. So I want you to remember that as we think about reaching today. Let's bow for a word of prayer, okay? Gracious God, we give you thanks for this day, this opportunity to celebrate your love out here in this beautiful outdoors, and help us to reach out and share your love with others. Watch over these children and keep them safe. Amen. I have more candy here. You can attack me afterwards, and I'll give you some.
I want candy.
Yeah. All right. Thank you, Dave. And thank you, those of you who participated in the children's message, for accepting candy from a stranger. Don't normally do that, though. We're going to go to the Lord in prayer this morning. We'll start with a moment of silence. Then we'll lift up some prayers together. And then we'll join together in saying the Lord's Prayer. Let's pray. God, you are so good. God, you are so good. You are so faithful. You are so full of mercy and grace and love. And Lord, you are so full of light and truth. And God, you have such a way with your children. And God, we are grateful. Grateful for who you are. Grateful for the relationship through Jesus that we can have on a daily basis with you. Lord, thank you for Jesus. Lord, as we gather for worship today, thank you, Lord, that through your Spirit, you meet us right here in this place. So, God, we come to you as your dearly loved children, and we pray, Lord, fill us anew. Fill us, God, with your Spirit. Guide us. Strengthen us. Give us your wisdom. Help us to know you, God, more and more and more. God, help us to taste and see that you are so good. And that your love lasts forever. God, this morning, thank you. As we gather for worship today, thank you for the church, for this particular expression of the church, but Lord, for the church throughout this world today, and the church who's gone on to glory, who gathers around your throne to worship you. God, thank you that we're all part of this incredible body, this expression of incredible light and love and truth. And God, thank you for this specific expression here in this community. And God, for the challenges, for the opportunities, God, for the blessings that you lay before us as a church, to be able to reach out into our communities, into our workplaces, into the schools, into the marketplace. Lord, to share your love with those around us in the unique ways, God, that you've called us to do that. God, I love it that our church loves to love on people. And I thank you, Lord, for missions like Ryan's Case for Smiles, for Habitat for Humanity, and all of the other organizations and ministries that we've partnered with. And Lord, all of the other organizations and ministries around our communities that we may or may not know anything about that are making such an incredible impact on people's lives. God, pour out your blessing upon each one of these ministries, strengthen them, provide for the needs that they have, and God, continue to guide them as they reach out with your love. God, thank you that we are not the only church here in this community, in the communities that are represented in worship today. God, thank you for each one of the churches, Lord, as they gather for worship in different ways, expressing their worship in different ways today, Lord. We pray you would pour out your Holy Spirit upon them. God, that you would strengthen and encourage them and guide them in the important work, God, that they have before them. as they seek to make Jesus known in powerful ways, in the ways you've given them to do that. God, thank you for the communities that are represented in worship today. God, would you bless these communities? Lord, be with the least that are in our communities, those that are struggling today, that are having a hard time for different reasons. Lord, draw them to yourself. Help them to know the love of God poured out in Jesus to bring hope and encouragement and strength and needs. Lord, we ask that you would provide. God, thank you. Thank you, Lord, for your faithfulness. Lord, we pray for our nation. Lord, we are so blessed as a nation. And we pray for our leaders, God, that you would be with them, that you would guide them, give them wisdom. Lord, strengthen their hands to do what you've called them to do. May they be on their knees before you, Lord. If they aren't praying people, Lord, put it on their hearts to pray. Lord, we pray you would guide them in the important decisions that are needing to be made. God, thank you for the men and women who serve faithfully in so many different roles, from our first responders to those that serve in the military, or those that serve in the medical profession, our teachers who are preparing to go back into the classrooms. Lord, all that serve faithfully, thank you, Lord, for their service. Bless them, encourage them, guide them in the important work they have before them. God, we know that there are many around our nation, many around the world that are struggling today. There are nations around our world today that are struggling. God, would you pour out your healing power and your presence into these places, Lord, where you are so desperately needed. God, that you would provide the help that's needed. God, that you would give wisdom to those that lead. And God, where there's pain, where there's suffering around our world today, speak life and healing and hope and provision. And God, we thank you that you are with those who are the most weak and vulnerable. God, this morning as we gather for worship, thank you for family. God, those you've placed in our lives as well as those who are blood relatives, Lord, thank you for them. And God, we ask that you would bless those that we're close to today. May they know the very heartbeat of God in their lives, bringing hope and encouragement, Lord, bringing what's needed in their lives. And may they come to know, if they don't already, Lord, the incredible love that you have for them. May they come to know the love poured out in Jesus. God, you are so good. And we thank you, Lord, for the many ways that you pour out blessing. Guide us, Lord, as we lift this prayer that Jesus taught his disciples to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Thank you.
Scripture this morning is from 1 Peter 4, 7 through 10. The end of the world is coming soon. Therefore, be earnest and disciplined in your prayers. Most important of all, continue to show deep love for each other, for love covers a multitude of sins. Carefully share your home with those who need a meal or a place to stay. God has given each of you a gift from his great variety of spiritual gifts. Use them well to serve one another. The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
You may be seated. Would you please pray with me once again? God, we thank you for your holy word. Lord, we thank you that as we turn to the scriptures, as we open our Bibles, Lord, they're not just words written down on a page eons ago that have no bearing upon us today. But God, your word speaks powerfully to us. Through your Holy Spirit, Lord, speak to us once more, your holy word, into our hearts, our minds, our spirits, that we would hear, Lord, what you would have to say to us today. And Lord, I pray that the words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts would be pleasing in your sight, our great rock and redeemer. Amen. So today we have the opportunity, those of you that are going to be participating, we have the opportunity to go to Warren Dunes in Michigan. And I know many of you have been there before. I've spoken with you about it. Many of you have fond memories of childhood going out to Warren Dunes. Many of you have later adult years. And there's other memories about going to Warren Dunes. But as I think about Warren Dunes and I think about parks like that, I think about paths. Because there's often paths that are created through these special parks where we can walk through them to get from point A to get to point B. How many of you have traveled on the Appalachian Trail? I'm just curious to see. Raise your hand. Okay, I don't get to see those that are joining us virtually, but I see a number of folks here that are with us in person that have walked the trail. And there's a starting point way down south, and then there's an ending point way up north, or vice versa, depending on which direction you're going on the Appalachian Trail, right? But many times people join the trail somewhere in the middle or along the pathway. And as we think about the discipleship pathway, and as I've been thinking about this, it's been really helpful for me to kind of think through what exactly is a disciple of Jesus and what does a discipleship pathway look like. What I come to realize is that so many of us have been on this pathway for so many years. And what's interesting as I talk to you about the pathway is that so many of you have joined in the pathway, being a disciple of Jesus, in different ways and in different stages of life. I was speaking with a gentleman who's 86, almost 86 years old this past week. And he said, I joined this pathway at a very late stage of my life. And he says, I look back on my life and I think, why did I not start this journey sooner? And as he thought back on his life and he thought about why he didn't start this journey sooner, he realized, looking back on his life, that God was constantly calling him. And isn't that the way life is? In so many different ways, God is calling us. And it's interesting, as I've thought about the discipleship pathway, and that first step is seek. I'm going to do the children's message. Seek. Every single one of us, no matter who we are, no matter how we grew up, whether we grew up in church or not, whether we grew up with parents that were good or parents that were challenged, every single one of us has a desire to know God, to know God's love, and to know God's purpose for our lives. We're all hardwired for that. Now, you talk to somebody that doesn't believe in God, their perspective may be a little different on this. Their perspective may be like this. They may say, I've sensed something for my life, and I've tried to follow that. But at the heart of this first step on the pathway that we talked about several weeks ago, seek, is an inbred part of who we are, that God created every single one of us with a desire, a longing to be loved and to have purpose. And every single one of us was built and designed and born into this world with a hunger to know the presence of God. The next step in the pathway, and Eric Schaefer shared with us a couple of weeks ago, that step is engage. Because just because we seek, because we're hungry and we're longing for something, for meaning, for purpose, to be loved, just because we're hungry and we're longing for that doesn't mean that somehow it just magically happens in our lives. Oh, sure, God works in our lives in different ways. And I imagine if I talked to each one of you, you could share some stories about how you've sensed God working in your life over the course of your life. But as Eric talked about the importance of engaging, and I loved his story. If you didn't hear that story, it's a great story about he and his wife, Lynn, and how they courted and made the commitment that they were not ever going to get married. And then God had different plans, and they ended up getting married. And the importance of the engagement. I'm making a commitment. A commitment to what? A commitment to God. Recognizing that God has been pursuing me all the while, as I've hungered and longed for love and purpose. And so we take that step when we realize that there's a God in heaven who created us, who knows us, and who loves us so much. And he calls us to know him as well. And we say yes to the incredibly gracious offer that he gives to us through Jesus. And we engage on the journey of life by saying yes to God. And then the next step, last week, Pastor Dave shared with us the importance of continuing to grow, to not just sit there like a marriage. We get engaged, we get married, or we are committed to somebody and we're walking the journey of life with them. We don't just kind of set them to the side and say, okay, you got your place here, I got my place here, and just do your thing. But there's a growth that happens in that relationship over time, for that relationship to be healthy. And in the same way, our relationship that we have the opportunity to have with God, we're called to engage in, but also to grow in. And Dave shared with us a message talking about the wisdom and the knowledge from Colossians that we can grow in. So much more than just head knowledge, although that's part of it, but much more that relationship. As we walk with God, as we journey the pathway of life with God, we continue to grow in our relationship. We grow closer. We grow more intimately with God to the point, just like with a good, long, healthy marriage, the one knows what the other one's going to do before the other one even does it. The one knows what the other one's thinking before they even say anything. I see the smiles on the faces. You know that we grow so close to God, that we know the very heartbeat of God. And when God calls us to reach, and that's where we are today. And I don't want to say the final step on the pathway, but in a way it is. Because this pathway, as I think about this pathway, it's almost like it goes around in circles. Because the very moment we start reaching out to somebody else with love, and Dave, thank you for that children's message this morning, and I'm going to hit you up for candy later. The very minute that we reach to somebody else, you know what happens? God continues to pour into us his love. And we continue to sense that need for God's presence in our lives. And no matter how close we grow to God in our relationship, we continue to sense that pulling and that longing. And we continue to seek. Jeremiah 29 says, if you seek me, you will find me. If you seek me with all of your heart, I will be found by you, says the Lord. And he goes on to talk about leading us out of captivity As we seek God, there's a deeper seeking, a deeper longing. And think about the relationships you have. There's a deeper relationship that forms as we go through this cycle of seeking, engaging, growing, and reaching. Let me land on reach today, since that's what I'm supposed to be speaking on. How do we reach? In what ways do we reach? How do we know if the reaching that we're doing is the right kind of reaching? How do we know when is the right person to reach out to? Maybe I think too much. When God puts in us His Spirit, the Holy Spirit has a way of stirring within us, first of all, a longing to continue to seek after God, a longing to continue to grow in engagement with God, but also a longing to reach out to those around us. Now, Mama and Daddy told me to be kind to people. I learned that from an early age, and I'm sure many of you did as well. Your parents instilled in you, hopefully instilled in you, some important lessons of life, of how to be with people and how to treat people. And we remember the golden rule, do unto others as you would have them do unto you. Boy, that was drilled into my brain, and I imagine many of yours. And so we have within us those reminders from our upbringing of how important it is how we treat each other. And so because of those important reminders that we were brought up on, that kick into gear every time we come in contact with somebody, they're there. But when the Holy Spirit fills us with the presence and the love of God, it goes way beyond that, way beyond a sense of duty. Oh, Mama and Daddy told me I got to be nice to people, so I guess I better be nice to people, especially that person over there that's being so nasty. Goes way beyond that. As God fills us with His Spirit and His love and His presence, God gives us a heart for people. And it would be tough for us, as we're filled with God's love and God's Spirit, it would be tough for us not to reach out to those around us. I shared with you a couple of months ago how I felt like God asked me through the chaplain of the jail system here in Kosciuszko County if I would be a chaplain of one of the blocks in the prison. Pastor Jared from Pathway Church is the chaplain, and he asked me if I would be willing to consider serving. And I thought, there is no way I am going to do that. That is scary to me. But I've tried to learn that I need to pray about things first instead of just snap responding. And so I prayed about it, and it didn't take long for the answer to come back. Sometimes I pray about stuff, and I'm still waiting. It's still out there for a few things I've asked about. But this came right back, and the Lord said to me, I have this for you for this season right now. And so I went. And when I went into that jail, I thought, you know what? I'm a pastor. I've got the training. I've got the experience. I've got the position. But you know what? When you go into a jail block with 20 guys that you don't know what they did, why they're in jail, you don't know their history, all of that goes out the window. Well, not completely. But you know what? There were times I would go to jail. I walked to jail on Wednesdays to be with these guys. And on the way to jail, when I first started going, I thought, okay, here's what I'm going to do. And I map out a plan, because I thought that's what I needed to do. Yeah, I see the nodding heads. Okay, I've got my plan. Here's what I'm going to do. And from the moment I walk into that block, all of those plans went out the window. But you know what the problem is? I had something I had to do. I had to reach these guys. And I had the goods to be able to do it. And I knew I had the goods to do it. And so I kept trying to make my plan work. Because, darn it, a good plan should work. And I had a good reach out plan, and it just did not work. And the harder I tried, the worse it got. And so I left that jail, and I thought, I'm a failure. I shouldn't even go back again. I think I'm going to contact the chaplain and say, I don't think I'm a good fit for this. And I felt the Spirit of God speaking to my heart, saying, trust me. Just trust me. God cares more deeply for those guys that are in that block than I ever could. And there are so many people around us in need, aren't there? It doesn't take long to find them. They may be in our family. And the temptation that I have is thinking, okay, I just got to do it. I know what I'm going to do, and I know how I'm going to do it, and here's what I'm going to do, and I'm going to do it. Y'all, there's nothing wrong with that. Go into it with a plan. Nothing wrong with that. But here's the thing. Listen for the leading of God's Spirit. When it comes to reaching out to other people, and here's the thing they told me going into jail. They said, if you are disingenuous, if you're faking it with these guys, they're going to see right through it. And they do. They have the gift of seeing right through a bunch of crud. The Spirit said, listen to me. And so every Wednesday when I walk to jail now, this is my prayer. Lord, I have an idea of what I'm going to say. I have an idea of what I'm going to do. But ultimately, God, I want to lean on you. So show me. Show me what I can do today. Show me what I can say today. Show me if I just need to shut my mouth today and listen as I reach out. Because it's not me reaching out. Well, it is. But it's God reaching out. It's not me seeking. I mean, it is. But ultimately, it's God. It's not me engaging. Because even in the engaging, God gives me the strength to be able to do that. It's not me growing. I can set myself up to learn, to grow, to expand my knowledge, my understanding, and that's important. But ultimately, it's not me. It's God. And in Peter's letter today, as he addressed the church, boy, this is all over Peter's words. As he tries to share with the church this important lesson that we have an incredible Savior, Jesus, who has set us free from sin and death, but also set us free to walk this journey, to be able to seek after God with everything that we are, to engage in that relationship with God more and more, and to grow in that, and then to reach out to others. So no matter where you have joined in on the discipleship pathway, no matter where it is you've plugged in, or no matter whether you have done that yet or not, there may be some that are hearing this today that have never, ever even thought about this. That there's a God in heaven who knows you and who loves you deeply, who has walked with you through this whole time of life, wherever you are in life, whether you're aware of it or not. And this God who's calling you to know him. And if you've never said yes to the love of God poured out in Jesus, there is no better time to jump on the pathway. All he asks is that you say, Jesus, I need you. Jesus, I want to be with you and to walk with you. Jesus, when he walked through the towns where he ministered, he called his disciples. They weren't qualified. They were a real interesting ragtag team that he called. And all he did was he said, come and follow after me. And that's what he calls us to do. And as Peter shares his heart with the church, he says, church, Jesus is still calling you to follow on this pathway. So if you've never done that before, just say, yes, Jesus, I believe and I receive and I join you in this pathway. And for those of us who have joined in this pathway long ago, and I know there's many of you that have been walking this road for a lot of years, just like I have, and we continue to seek to know God better. We continue to engage in deeper, deeper levels with God's Spirit at work within us. And as we do that, we continue to grow in our understanding in our closeness with God. And we're impelled. We're impelled by the love of Christ through the power of His Holy Spirit to reach out to those around us. Because I don't know if you've noticed, but as I look around the community, as I look around my world, there are people who are so hungry to know that there's a God in heaven who gives a care. So Lord, we thank You that You invite us to experience Your presence as we walk with Jesus in this life. So Lord, I pray for each one of us, wherever we are on this journey, or even if we've never stepped on this pathway, God, that You would awaken us more and more to Your incredible love for us and Your call on our lives. Lord, help us to understand and to connect with that deep, deep longing, and help us to seek You. And Lord, as we seek You, help us to engage deeper and deeper with You. And as we engage deeper and deeper with You, Lord, help us to continue to grow in wisdom and in knowledge and in relationship with You. And as Paul prays, Lord, that we would be filled with all the fullness of God. And Lord, as You fill us, as You call us to look beyond ourselves, to lay our lives down just like Jesus did, God, help us to reach out to those that You place in our pathway to share the love of God. Thank You, Lord. We ask this in the wonderful name of Jesus our Lord. Amen. Oh, that's right. We're supposed to take up the offering, aren't we? Yes, bless the offering. Would you all stand up as we receive the offering this morning? I always forget that. Thank You for these gifts, for these tithes and these offerings. Lord, we ask that You would bless them, use them to further Your kingdom purposes. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, we pray. Amen. Home. Thank you, praise team, for being here to help out with music this morning. Again, thank you so much for coming out and being a part of worship. Thank you for tuning in through Oldies 101 through our YouTube channel as well. As you go from this place, go with that reminder that you're on that pathway. And as God leads you by the power of His Holy Spirit, look to the Spirit to lead you as you walk this journey of faith. God bless you.